And welcome to the Zebra Clan Stadium. It's the West Cumbrian Derby, the first one, or the first one that matters. It's Town versus Haven. Town line-up, Jack Murphy, Sam Forrester, Paddy Whiteley, Jared Stack, Brett Carter, Jamie Duran, Carl Forber, Tom Walker, Graham Mackinson, Mark Shackley, Brett Phillips, Kurt Orton and Liam McAvoy, and that is a very big pack. The subs for Town are Callum Phillips, Carl Ostrom, Latu Fifita and Stephen Scully. Haven line-up, Richard Lepore, Craig Calvert, Rodri Lloyd, Connor Holliday, Jordan Burns, Brett Seymour, Thomas Coyle, Stephen Fox, James Newton, Ben Davies, Dave Allen, Scott McAvoy and Dion Eyre. The subs for Haven are James Robinson, Jesse Joe Parker, Tyler Heppy and Ted Chappellhow. Well, there's two young lads in there from the Widnes Academy side, but apparently they're two good lads. Obviously, you haven't seen them yet. This will be their first outing. Referee, Mr. Tom Crashley, and Good Friday 2015, and off we go. And I think this pitch is going to cut up very, very badly. It's in better condition than I thought it would be. When we came here about three quarters of an hour ago, I was expecting to see puddles lying on the pitch, but it is fairly dry, but I have a feeling that it will cut up. It's got to be soft on top. So Tom with the first use. And that was Tom Walker. So Mr. Crashley keeping Whitehaven back to that 40-metre line. That's the Town 40-metre line. And both teams coming off big defeats last weekend. Whitehaven 60-0 at Lee, and Town put a much better performance in at Bradford than they did the week before in the Cup, but still came away 36-6 down. So all to play for here. And that's not a bad kick, that. And Craig Calvert will have to be careful. He's running across his front of his own line there. Now, I don't think that's a good idea. I always think he should just put your head back and go. And Haven do have possession, but they're in a bit of a poor position there. They're 10 metres from their own try line. This is third tackle going in. That's Stephen Fox. Stephen Fox has moved up from centre to prop. Only seen him once in the when Whitehaven were. Sorry, seen him twice. Whitehaven beat London, and then they were beaten by Featherstone in the Cup. And knocked back there. That was a good three-man tackle. I was going to say two, but there's actually three in that. So this is the kick. And Whitehaven one or two missing today, including John Paul Brocklebank, who's just got back from a pre-arranged trip to America, I believe. So I think Haven could really have done with him out there today. And Mr. Crashley shouted hell very early there, mind you. So Town coming down this right-hand side. A bit of a slap there, but that's all it was. Oh, that's good tackling there. Really knocked Jared Stack back there. Crowd building up nicely here. It's bigger than I thought it was going to be. It's not the best of days here today. So Mr. Crashley says to Whitehaven, get back to me, and they did. Now they're going to... Oh, that looked slightly forward there. Oh, and that's kicked on and picked up. It did certainly look like a forward pass, mind, that the one that split the Whitehaven defence, but in the end, they lost possession and just kicked it on. That looked forward as well. Oh, that's good running there from that lad, 21. I'll just look for it. In fact, it's... Well, I've got him down here as Dion Eyre, but I don't think that was Dion Eyre. Yeah, Dion Eyre's 25, yeah. Can't read me on right now. Never mind, we'll get on with the game. And Haven got a nice position here. My God, Stephen Fox, look at him there. He's now filled out. Now then, what can Haven do? They're running out of tackles here. That was Brett Seymour there taking the line on. They're exactly 10 metres out here. Opening minutes, 0-0. It's a kick. And that should be no problem at all. That's a 20 restart, and Haven need to get back there to that to the 30-metre line. They're still offside, some of them here. The referee could blow them. I think if the town player had run, in fact it was Brett Carter, I think if he'd run at some of those Whiteham players who were obviously offside, the referee would have had to give a penalty. Now this is ex-Avon man. Oh, that ball go there. No, must be in my eyes. This is Mark Shackley. The town with a nice line out there to let this go. I think really this should have been a dummy runner there, and that ball should have went out to the centre and winger, but it didn't. So far, just a good old-fashioned West Cumbrian derby, and Mr. Crashley says final tackle. So town 21 metres out, and there's Jamie Doran, the Whiteham base player, oh, nicely held there by Craig Calvert. I've got Lee here with me, one of the camera operatives for ProCam. Have you played against Jamie Doran, Lee? No. He's a bit shy of the microphone. He says no. So this is Haven, nicely coming away from their own try line. No signal from Mr. Crashley, so there might be a couple of tackles left. I don't think there'll be much more. And that looked like James Newton, who played for Town about a couple of seasons ago. I think he was on loan from Hull KR. Is that going out on the full? No, it's not. A good kick, actually. It isn't a 40-20, though, is it? I don't think. Let's have a look at Mr. Crashley. Oh, it is. Yeah. I think some of the Whiteham supporters here knew it was going to be 40-20. I thought he was just over the line there, but obviously his standing foot must have been... just the right side of the line as far as Whiteham are concerned. So Mr. Crashley and his two touch judges, I haven't got their names, but they were in no doubt. I don't know what the hold-up's for, but we'll get on with it. Whiteham getting six start here today with most bookies. Some are going off eight. And so far the pitch isn't too bad, but you can see it is starting to kick up a bit. And if the rain continues, it's only going to make it a bit worse. But this is a third tackle coming in now, and Haven 12 metres away from the post. Nice passing across the line. Oh, I don't know whether he would have got through. I'd give him that ball there, but that was Dave Allen there wearing the number 11. He was on the crash ball, but he didn't get it. So Haven flirting with that 10-metre line. Who's going to open the scoring here? Still 0-0. This is Stephen Fox. Thought the referee was going to blow for a forward pass there. He sent a motion with his whistle, but then he changed his mind. Oh, nice little kick. But, was he took it? No. Well, Haven will have to get back here. It's going to be a quick 20 restart. And he has topped it, I should say. And that's Jamie Doran. His relatives are all big Whiteham supporters, especially his dad. So it's could be a funny old thing in the Doran household tonight up at Kells. But certainly he was he's Super League. Oh, now then, that should have went out, and that'll be a penalty. Actually slipped into the tackle, but nevertheless he still caught him. Now then, will Carl Forber take the early 2 points? I think he probably will. I think that ball should have went out, mind. Oh, in fact, Carl Forber's kicking to touch. So the fans had the chances of opening the scoring with a try. And we'll see how Haven measure up to this set of six. And 9 metres out, 5 tackles to go, and Stephen Fox tangled up there with that player. This is a lad I have a lot of time for. I really think he'll make it, Liam McAvoy, but nicely tackled. And they've loaded. Ooh, some of those passes look to be going forward. Well, they're literally 1 yard out there. He could sell the dummy, Graham Mattinson, but he didn't. Yeah, and over he goes. It was as simple as that. It was just a nice little simple pass, and at first I thought Graham Mattinson was going to do the show and go there from the base of the ruck, but he didn't. He gave it off, and I think that was Liam McAvoy, actually. I've just been talking about him. Has crashed over for the opening score. So Carl Forber to increase his lead from 4-0 to 6-0. Very little doubt about that. And over it goes. So Town 6, Haven 0. So Town off to the perfect start, and ball falls off the tee. So we'll have to give a try again. So at the moment, the Bookies have got a draw. As I said before, they had Avon down for the sixth start. How was that bounce? Nice one in the end. And that was the first call of get him on side I've heard so far this afternoon. And Dave Allen, good tackle there. That looks like Brett Phillips. I'm afraid their numbers are starting to get very dirty, and they'll get dirtier as the game goes on. There's the try scorer, Liam McAvoy. Go from dummy half here. Evan should know all about Graham Mattinson. He'd done it down the recreation ground for a few years before he found his way to well, Derwent Park then. And that could roll dead. And then again, it might not, and it won't. So that's a good kick, that. And Craig Calvert did just enough there to clear his own line. I think they'll just go from dummy half, and that's exactly what Haven have done. And it's Dion Ayre. Now Scott McAvoy is in the pack these days. Still got his centre number on, number four. Stephen Fox. So White haven't cleared their line nicely there. And that Haven man, it was Richard Lepore, he was right at his elbow. Haven trying another 40-20, but it won't be. Ooh, and Brett Carter taking an enormous amount of time to pick that ball up. And gets falls to a good tackle for his pains. So Haven have got Town back on their own 20. And that's Jack Murphy, ex-Wigan lad. So far, the referee hasn't caught anybody for offside. It has been at one penalty, I think. It went to Town and they scored off it. Or off the back of it. So a couple of tackles left, and Town try that left-hand side. But Brett Phillips quickly snuffed out. There's the kick coming now. Just right down the middle. Invite Haven to run it back from their own try line. And Craig Calvert makes about 5 or 6 metres before he's downed there by Tom Walker. Dion Ayre at the dummy half position. There was a crack on the Workington website this morning. Somebody put on that Jesse Joe Parker wasn't playing. Well, he is in the 17, but he's starting on the bench, and it makes you think if Jesse Joe Parker's maybe carrying some sort of a injury. Of course, both teams have got another game on Monday, so it's a quick turnaround. That's not a bad little kick, that. That's going to hold up, I think. Oh, it is. But cleared his line nice there. That tackle seemed to be around the throat area, but the referee said it's okay. So on second tackle, Town still inside their own 20. It's Brett Carter coming off his wing to help the forwards out. Mr. Crashley telling the Haven players to get back to him there, and they were just slightly in front. And he does tend to play a rather big 10 metres, does Mr. Crashley. That's Mark Shuckley. Good looking run there, but that Avon player did just enough. In fact, I think it was Brett Seymour, and certainly, Kirk Calvert getting plenty of practice at running the ball back, but he laid that one off to Richard Laporte. I think he got a call for it, actually. And I reckon this Richard Laporte can run. I've never actually seen him on the break yet, but he was well thought of at Oldham. That was Dion Eyre. Just invited the tacklers to come in, and they did just that. Inside ball to Scott McAvoy, tackled by his ex-Avon mate there, Greg Mattinson. Oh, good-looking run there. It was a nice ball, that, but well tackled in the end. Three-man town tackle. Now, Avon could try a 40-20. Could actually put a chip over the top. Well, what they've done is they've just gone it right up the middle, and that'll be Jack Murphy. I'll run that back. And they really are getting the noses through the first line of defence here at town, which is a bit worrying for the Haven contingent here. But that was a much better tackle. There's the halfway line. Liam McAvoy turned there to offload. He does have a good offload game, but too much heavy traffic there. Now they've loaded this side town, but tackle was good. There'll be a couple of tackles left. They're inside the wide open 40, and that's just a cross kick, and referee's pointing a man offside there for town. So this is Richard Laporte looking for the gap, but it was quickly closed. In fact, it was Brett Carter who put the tackle in. So both wingers, Richard Laporte is actually fullback, but he can play on the wing. Clearing the line now, the wide open forwards will have to come into play now. And there's Stephen Fox. So wide open still on their own 20 metre line here, and they're halfway through this set. Switch it to the right hand side. But certainly the town tackling is very keen. Avon were pointless up here in the pre-season Ikes of the Trophy, 26-0 I think. And they're pointless so far in this league game. Oh, that'll be... Oh! I think he's going to score here. Yes, it's Jamie Doran, is it? Scoring against his hometown. It was just a kick and a hope there, but it worked off nicely there for the Wigan lad, and he scored Town's second try. So Town in at the corner, and 10-0. All right. So that kick, very poor attempt for a man of Carl Forber's calibre. He's if he does miss, it's only just, but that time he just didn't catch it right. So the score remains the same. It's Town 10, Avon 0. And we've got Ted Chapelow on now, wearing the number 27. We think Ben Davis was the one that went off. We'll find out shortly. It was, yeah. So, yeah. So Ben Davis off and Ted Chapelow on. So Town certainly got the bit between the teeth now. They're 10-0. Oh, that's very unlucky, that, really. He was trying to clear the ruck, but caught the Town player with his knee, and the referees penalised it. They do tend to these days. I do agree with it, mind. It's up to the player to clear the ruck, and not up to the man with the ball. He got up, tried to clear the ball, and was just knocked over. So this takes Town even closer to the Avon try line. Oh, not happy with that one. This young lad, Ted Chapelow, will give the penalty away. He looks dead keen. He's here coming at the tackle now. He's quite a big lad. I think he's about 6'3", according to the witness website. Oh, and that Town man's injured there, is he? maybe just tired. It's bound to be wearing out there. It's it is cutting up now really badly, this this pitch. And Town switching the ball about delightfully here. Jack Murphy looking to offload, but three men got in and stopped it. So about 15 metres out from the Haven try line, looking to score the third try in the opening half hour. Oh, that looks dangerous, but just closed the door now then. Will Graham Mattison go himself this time? No, gives it off. And Jamie Doran puts the kick in. And, yeah, well, Craig Calvert didn't take a chance there. I think it would have bounced dead mine, but didn't take a chance and knocked it dead. So Evan will have to launch this from underneath their own bar. Still haven't got the clock working there on the scoreboard, but it's probably just over 20 minutes gone. Oh, that could be useful if it bounces right, but it bounced nice there for Jared Stack. And the big second rower who's playing in the centre, it took the line on. So it's just constant pressure here from Town. And there's a substitution for Town. So Mark Shackley did go off. He looked as though he was a bit shaken after that last tackle he took. Well, if they let this go, they could be in. Trying to... Oh, Jack Murphy. Is he going into touch? Oh, knock on he's given. I think he's given it... He's knocked it, the ball on against the Whitehaven player. He did seem to shoot out of his hands and then he recollected it. So that was a bit of a let-off there. But I think Jack Murphy had to try and let the ball go because... He was in grave danger of getting put over the sideline, so Evan will get head and feed, but they are only 10 metres away from their own try line. And still no sign of Jesse Joe Parker. Looks like Evan are making a substitution here. Could be Tyler Heppy looking at his size. No, I didn't. Ooh, quick play of the ball there, and Dion Air takes the line on. Ted Chapelau, the sub. That's a nice little kick, that. That's, look at this lad here chasing the Town player, and he's got him as well. In fact, that's... Jordan Burns, yeah. Certainly showed his speed there, did Jordan. So Town have to launch out from underneath their own bar. So how quickly it goes from one end to the other. I think they'll just go off a length right down the middle. Yep. And... Seven here now, 20 metres out, four tackles left. Dion Air. Looks like Tyler Happy's wanting this ball here, but he's not going to get it. I think Tyler Happy was used as a dummy runner there, but it didn't work. And good tackling there by the Town defence. Oh, right into his hands there. In fact, it was Jamie Doran, I think, who gratefully gobbled that one up like an Easter egg. So Town, 11 metres from their own try line, following that missed kick. I must think you're better kicking it into the ground when you're close to the opponent's try line rather than... kicking it 4 or 5 feet off the ground. It's just nice height for catching the ball. That. I think Town could try a 40-20 here. They're in a good position for it. And kick downfield. Nicely fielded there by Richard Lepore. And that's a lot too for Theta. First time I've seen this lad. He's a big lump of a lad, isn't he? Number 17 with the clean shirt on. He's been getting a bit of stick mind off some of the town fans on the town website. But some of these lads come over, you know, from these South Sea Island areas, and they really aren't fully fit when they come over. I think town can expect some big things off him once the grounds harden up a bit. And Tyler Happy knocked back by Graham Mattinson. Don't know whether they're onside, those Avon players, but it doesn't matter anyhow now because the town man's got the ball. I think at the moment the penalties, I think, are 2-0 to town and 10-0 on the scoreboard as well, so Avon are having to do it the hard way. I tell you what, mind, that Dion Air put some tackles in. He's come with quite a big reputation, played for Papua New Guinea in the World Cup last year. Is that a 40-20? Was he outside? Or, well, we'll find out here. I'm not quite sure. Yeah, it is a 40-20. So it's a 40-20 each, and that gives town a perfect position here. Around about 25 minutes played. I make it any, I think it was just after three when they kicked off. Still haven't got that scoreboard clock working. So, down from the base of the scrum. Jamie Dorn gets to his feet, plays the ball back. They've certainly got a nice line out here of town. They've loaded that left-hand side if they get it out that far. Jamie Doran gives a nice ball off. Oh, and if they could have got that ball out wide, I think it was a walk in there, but Petty Whiteley got caught in possession. Stepped inside there. Still going, mind. Oh, oh, no, that's okay. No, they put him down okay. Graham Mattinson. Can Avon keep them out on this set of six? They're still, what, 2 metres away from the try line. Is it going to be a kick coming? Oh, and Craig Calvert picked it up nicely. And maybe 5 or 6 years ago, Craig would have picked that up and went and putting the ball down now at the other end, but he was well marshalled there, mind you. Didn't have much chance. So Avon clearing the line. They're still only just crossed their own 20 metre line there, halfway through the set. So James Robinson comes on. I suppose that booing was a bit unwanted, but I suppose he'd be friendly at the same time. James played for town for about, was it 13 years, I think, up here. Now, of course, a Whitehaven player and a Whitehaven director. So around about half an hour gone now, so about 10 minutes left of this first half, and still town 10, Avon 0. And if Avon don't score in this opening half, that'll be a game and a half where they haven't scored a point up here. That's Callum Phillips, is it? Inside ball. Oh, this is Jack Murphy. Oh, that's nice play there. Whoa, run into the referee there. But, yeah, that was lovely play. That was right off the training pitch, wasn't it? It was interplayed between the forwards and the backs, and Town go in for their third try on the half-hour mark, roughly. So Town starting to run away with this now. It's Town 14, Haven 0. Haven are home to Doncaster on Sunday. Town have to go down to Lee, and that won't be any picnic. There really are rattling scores up these days at Lee. Doncaster played on Wednesday night, actually, so that'll give them a bit of an advantage over Haven. They've had two days more rest before Monday's game. Lee, I think, are away to Hunslet today in South Leeds. So, Town 16, Haven 0. Haven to kick off, and I've had plenty of practice at that in the first half. And the referee eventually shouts held. I think he was waiting there in case there was an offload, but there was three Haven tacklers in there. And really got the bit between the teeth here in the Town. You can see they're on the toes here, every man wanting the ball. Oh, there's a good tackle there. There's a bit of outweighed there, I would think, by two or three stones was Tyler Heppy, but he certainly he stopped that man. Here's the kick. Is that going to go dead? And he does. So Richard Lepore will restart. And he's not going to get through like that. Well, I think he played for that, really, did Richard Lepore. Really didn't give Callum Phillips any chance at all there to get out the way. So can Haven take advantage of that? I think that's Haven's first penalty, actually. Town have had two. Now James Newton at the dummy half position. Yeah, and that'll be all on. It was really running in full pelt there was James Robinson, and of course the town faithful would love that. One of their old players getting put on his backside. So I'm afraid it's all been one-way traffic this game. The opening 5 minutes, they haven't had a fair share, maybe opening 10 minutes, but since then, and that's that move that they did for the last try, the third one, but Haven spotted it that time. So nice position here, be a couple of tackles left probably. Oh, almost knocked on there, Callum Phillips. Now then, Town have been here a few times this afternoon, a couple of metres away from the Haven try line. Well, I think that Town man took a chance there, man, because he could have been caught in possession. It was on light final tackle, but he could see the Haven men weren't standing square, so he ran right at them, and the referee obliged him by giving the penalty. So Town are going to kick this, and then there'll be three scores clear. It's a 16-0 at the moment. Yep, and over it goes. So Town 18, Haven 0. I make it about 5 minutes to half time. So Haven going to go a game and a half here at Derwent Park without scoring a point. To be honest, they really haven't looked dangerous in this first half. Going end over end, but nicely fielded there by Jared Stack. Oh, I could feel that one from up here. And that's much better tackling from Idaven there. That's the Town 40 metre line. Going from dummy half, oh, throws a dummy. But nicely spotted there. Certainly fooled me, I thought he passed the ball, but James Robinson didn't fool him. And they're running riot here, this Town. Can they get that ball away? Well, they have, but it'll be picked up by a Haven player. They really are cutting Haven to bits here. And Richard Lepore looks as though he's picked some sort of an injury up. I think he's maybe got mud in his eye, actually. I think that's probably what it is. But he looks in a bit of distress there, and he's calling for the trainer to come on, I think. Dion Air. It's the 40-metre line. So Haven shown a little bit of class there, but quickly snuffed out. Final tackle, Mr. Crashley says. Ooh, that's some height, that ball. Oof, but taken on his fingertips there by Jack Murphy. So this might be the last set of six before the half-time out. Can't come quick enough for Haven, I would think. Well, you really can't have any sympathy with that. You've got the opposition down deep inside their own half, probably halfway through the set, and then you're just pushing the tackle. So Town already 18-0 up. We're looking to go 22 and 24 up. Well, he shouted L, so just have to play it again. Once over, it was a scrum down, that, if they passed after the, as the referee shouted L. But I think the RFL came to the senses and just said, well, just go back and play it. That's exactly what they did. Why did man have to get out of the way? And he does. It was Tyler Heppy. Oh, nice inside ball there. But a good tackle by Dion Air. So there'll be two or three tackles. Oh, he's give it the other way. It really is crazy, you know, this. It's the referee's got to give a decision, but to be honest, my decision there would just be play on. There was nothing in that, really. Well, I think what he's saying is he penalised Haven for pushing the man, so he's now penalised Town for the same thing. Well, can Haven get something on the board before the half-time outer goes? And off we go. Good tackle in there, good three-man tackle. Not only tackle him, put him on his back. It's a Dion Air. Pushed Jamie Doran off there. And there's the hooter. So a great half-time score here for Town and the fans. It's Workington Town 18, Whitehaven 0. So welcome back to the Zebreclame Stadium. Town 18, Haven 0. And Haven to receive. And James Robinson will run it back. Oh, that ball's been pulled out. Also got Jesse Joe Parker on now. Didn't hear who he replaced. If he's gone into the centre, it'll either be Rodri Lloyd or Connor Holliday. But there is Jesse Joe. So he obviously, if he is carrying a knock, he's likely fit enough to play, but White haven't really are down to the bare bones. Oof, and that was a good solid hit. No doubt Town will have been told that Haven will come out all guns blazing for the first 10 minutes, so... Well, this is much better. Oof, right round the neck. Referee's got it right away. In fact, it was Perry Whiteley there that put that tackle in. Certainly a big lad for a centre. So, Irvin, second set, the start of the second half. And James Robinson taking his fair share of balls in. So, what, about 19 metres out from the try line. Oh, good pass, but well spotted by the Town defence. Oh, they haven't played basketball here. And he's given a forward pass. You can only think the touch judge has given it. It certainly looked okay from here. Was a bit of a delayed whistle, so I don't know whether they're wired up here at Derwent Park, but it certainly was a delayed whistle. Connor Holliday is still on there, so... Oh, that's a time chain, that. I skipped to Rodri Lloyd off, is he? 21? Burns. Yeah, in fact, it's, Jordan Burns gone off. So Haven with the first two sets in the second half, but came to naught following that forward pass. And this is Town's first set. And referee shouts held. Once they lift their leg off the ground, the referee has got to shout held. Oh, now then, got their line out going here, Town, if they can launch this wide. Oh, but that was good. White haven't just slid the defence along there nicely and snuffed the move out. And Richard Lepore having no... Never had any room to move in at all, the fullback, but that's testament to this tight Town defence. Certainly tightened it up today. And again, lifted off the floor, that was Dave Allen, so referee shouts held. Some pile of shouting going on, mind, when you can hear it plainly up here in this commentary box. So a final tackle, and Haven are five short of the halfway mark. And how's that bounce? So Haven got Town back about 2 metres from their own try line here, but they need to stay onside. Got to say the referee hasn't given any penalties for offside. They've just been for technicalities really. Town loaded this side, but decided just to play a safety first. Might put an early kick in here. Try for a 40-20. And Petty Whiteley again lifted up. Oh, that's unlucky that. I can only think it was pulled out. Yeah, in fact it was. That's what the referee gave. So it just puts Whitehaven under more pressure. And that's coming towards us. That's a good tackle there from Dion Eyre. And then slid down to his round about the hips area to put him on his back. Oh, good run from dummy half. I'm not sure if those Whitehaven players were onside, actually. The referee gave them the benefit of the doubt. I think he ran at them because he thought they weren't standing square. So they've come down this left-hand side. Nice little offload. But held in the tackle and finally put to ground. No signal from the referee. Couple of tackles left, I would think. Oh, they're putting an early kick in here, are they? No. In fact, he sells the dummy. Oh, and they could have Evan short on that side. Yeah, and they're in. That was poor tackling there by Evan. It was obvious what they were going to do there, Town, and they just stood off and run out of numbers, and Town go over for the fourth try. So 22-0, and Carl Forber looking to make it two dozen points. It's on the wrong side for him, actually. He's a right-footed kicker, but he's normally not far away. And that looks to be sailing wide, yeah. In fact, it didn't even reach the post, so stays the same, but it's a good score for Town. Town 22, 7-0. So Haven kick off, and I think some of them are over that halfway line before the boot hit the ball. I've got to say, there's not a great atmosphere here today, but I think there's a lack of Haven fans here, mind you. Oh, and there's another penalty. Well, they certainly had their fair share of penalties of Town, but he's actually said hand on the ball. All I seen was the ball on the ground, unless that's what made the ball hit the ground. But either way, that's a second penalty this second half for Town in quick succession. Right on the halfway line. The referee says play on. I think the ball did go back, mind you. There was no problem there. It looks like Mark Shackley back on there, is it? Yeah, it is, in fact, yeah. It's Mark Shackley. So Town in a great position here. Oh, and a nice little offload. I suppose you can do that when you're 22-0 up. And really, you would fancy them to get over again here. They've got a great position, and that Whitehaven defence looks rather fragile near their own try line. And here we go with that line out. And in we go, same side. Just absolutely cutting Whitehaven to bits here. And suddenly it's gone to 26-0. And this is more in line with what Carl Forber can do. He's halfway out between the right hand upright and the corner flag. So 26-0. And make that 28-0. Well, certainly a long way back for Haven, and they haven't even troubled the scoreboard operator yet. So Town 28, Haven 0, and about 30 minutes left. So Mark Shackley will drive that in against his old team. Stephen Fox doing his best there to make sure they couldn't offload the ball. And Callum Phillips is so good at that, isn't he, from the dummy half position. He just spots the gap and goes. Well, that time it was closed by Scott McAvoy. And they're trying that right on side again. They've certainly had a lot of glee in the first half and in the second half. Down the Whitehaven left-hand side. And where's that going? It's coming back, I think. Does anybody want it? Well, it's kick and pass, I think. And Craig Calvert tried his best there to get a bit of ground, but... Oh, the referee says not square, I think, at the play of the ball. Didn't actually see the signal there. Oh, in fact, he's given a head-eye shot. So Dave Holland spins in the tackle. All right.
Who's 21?
Rodri Lloyd.
Centre.
Oh. Yeah. And Richard Lepore caught in possession there, tried to offload, but it was a good tackle there and stopped it. Dion Air finds the 20 metre mark. Might have been running out of tackles here though. Oh, interception. You see that one coming. Don't know whether Richard Lepore is going to get to him or not, is he? Oh, well, you've got to give the lad praise for that. But he needs the release. Oh, and there's a yellow card coming. Well, that's all they ever needed, wasn't it? Well, he done wonders there to get back on side. Sorry, to get back and pull the man down, but the referee said he had his hand on the ball and the ball went loose, so he's penalised him. So now we have 12 men now for the next 10 minutes. And Town messing about with the kicked goal. They're going for the jugular here. They've got a 28-point lead here. And they're looking to put a big score on today. Of course, it'll all count at the end of the season. A good forward and against is as good as 1 point on the points difference. Oh, and that ball's gone. So that's got to be a knock-on. Referee's waiting for advantage, yep. So a bit of a relief there for Haven. But Richard Lepore, that's the first time I've seen the lad really having a good run, and he certainly covered some pile of ground there to stop that try. But he's paid the ultimate price there, 10 minutes in the bin. This is Jesse Joe Parker. Ooh, that looked to be around about the neck area there, but must have been just on the chest, upper chest. Well, he shouted held, so he'll have to penalise it. No, I could hear him up here shouting held, so the players should have heard it. So it's just damage limitation here for Haven. They'll be just wanting to make sure none of the players are injured. They've got this big match coming up against Doncaster on Monday. And no doubt Town will be in the same frame of mind for their daunting trip to the Leith Sports Village. Oh, and that's, well, it might pay off for them actually. That could have been intercepted, that, but in the end, is it Rodri Williams, I think, got his In fact, yeah, it was Rodri Williams. Sorry, Rodri Lloyd. I'll get his lad's name right. Oh, White haven't put a kick through. And I thought the referee was going to give that there at first. Same as though he was in two minds. And then I think he suddenly realised, hang on, he knocked on there. So we'll have to put a scrum down. So he's given a 10-metre scrum here for Town. Causing all sorts of bother, isn't he? Is Callum Phillips is so explosive from played it forward there, can't do that. Actually used to be a penalty that about five or six seasons ago, but nowadays they just give it as a knock on, even though it isn't a knock on. And Raven will get the scrum. So Raven, I'm just trying to see how they've dropped back there into that semi full back position. Obviously, Richard Laporte wears the one. He's probably 3 or 4 minutes into his 10 minutes. This is Jesse Joe. But met by a four-man Town wall there. So James Newton, the ex-Town player at the dummy half position, runs forward, gives a nice ball off there, but again that tackling, might even need to push the other way actually, but now then can they open their account for the afternoon? Oh, that's up, what's he giving? Offside, not standing square at the play of the ball. Maybe just top this and go here, probably as somebody saying take the two, but I think it's rather an ironic call rather than a Haven supporter. This is Stephen Fox. But those kind of balls there really are telegraphed. I think you're better off using players as dummy runners in situations like that. That was a nice little move there from Brett Seymour, but snuffed out. Oh, that's superb tackling, you know. This is as close as Whitehaven have been in what 50-odd minutes of play in this game. Well, that was played at, so that should be all on that. But, yeah, he's giving it all on. I think he was waiting for the call from the touch judge. Jesse Joe Parker. He's going at the touch, is he? No. He's just managed to get to ground. Which is his fellow Papua New Guinean, Dion Air. But you've got to give this Town defence full marks. And that's Connor Holliday there, put on his back. They even have probably lost about 5 or 6 metres into this set of six. Going for a run from dummy half. I think this might be final tackle, and it is. So one tackle to go. Dave Allen gives it off. Oh, and Town pluck it up. What's he given? Oh, he's saying he's been shoulder charge. Well, actually, a shoulder charge is supposed to be a yellow card these days. If that was a shoulder charge, or it was maybe just an obstruction the referee's given. But a shoulder charge these days is supposed to be a yellow card and on report. But I think it was just an obstruction he's given after he kicked the ball. So here we have got two or three penalties on the belt end there, and still don't really look as though they're going to cross this line. This is Dave Allen. Oh, that's great tackling there on the big second row. This is Scott McAvoy. So Haven getting closer all the time. James Newton. No, he's just short. And Haven in sixes and sevens here, as the saying goes. This is Jesse Joe Parker. Straightens it up. final tackle, and they just can't get over the try line. They've been here now for what seems like the last 10 minutes. And now this should be a 20 restart. This should be a 20 restart, so I'll have to be careful here. And the man who brings the ball back is the man who's who has to tap it, and that's exactly what he did there. This is Brett Carter. Oh, that's a superb tackle by Tyler Hepping. And I think, that's nice to say that. I think Jared Stack actually tapped him on the back there as much as to say a good shot. And there's another one. Well, maybe if having a tackle like this in the opening 40 minutes could have been a bit of a different game. Is that going to... And if that ball was still moving, all the Haven man had to do there was put one foot over the dead ball line and scoop it over. And that would have been a 20 restart. But instead, they put it dead. So for all that 5 minutes of excitement the Haven fans had there underneath the town post, it's come to naught, and they're at the other end now and having to kick out. It's reached the halfway line before it's picked up. Well, eventually. And you can still hear that ooh in the tackle. There's the 40 metre line, and Towner going across it. Oh, he's the break. Oh, actually slipped there as he was going through, but I think he still would have been tackled. Might have looked short on this side. Inside ball, but nicely spotted there. That was Dave Allen. He could see that move coming. Oh, yeah. Oh, he's got the forward pass. Forward pass. I'm going to say a nice little move, that. Very slick passing. But he's given a forward pass. So it'll be a 10-metre scrum for Haven. But they've opened the Whitehaven defence up so many times this afternoon. They've only... They've scored five tries, but they must have had at least double that in chances. And... some of the town supporters below saying, are you keeping the score down, lad? Well, I think Haven will be pleased for that decision. And it looks like Richard Lepore is ready for coming back on. So there's the Haven 20-metre line, their own 20-metre line. Stephen Fox checks that line on, but again, great tackling, and in there goes down in heap on the 40. Whitehaven could try a 40-20 here. Puts Town back onto their own 20-metre line there. Oh, how's that? Oh, I was given a knock down there. So it'll be head and feet to Town. Left here, and it looks like Connor Holiday are going off. Oh, Hitman bringing back on. Yeah, it looks like Jordan Burns coming back on. So one Kells lad for another one there. suspiciously like a knock-on there. The referee had a good look at that one, but I think he got his hand on the ball as it hit the ground. And Dave Allen putting some parlour tackles in, mind you. And his old team had a great win last night against Warrington. Well, why didn't he need to get out the way? Well, he could have penalised that, but he didn't. Oh, good tackle on Cal Forber. Final tackle, 20 metres out. Graham Mattinson back on, so I take it Callum Phillips has gone off. What's he giving here? Oh, has he got cramp? Well, so they'll just give the ball to another player. He's obviously gone down with cramp, that lad. So just play the ball from there. Right, referee says get on with it. And they do. A lot of height on that. Oh, that's a knock on though from Town. Oh, he's back out now, like, So Haven did not score last week, and the way it's going, looks as though they're not going to score this week, are they? To go two full games without a score isn't, it's not good, is it? And of course they'll meet again in about 7 weeks' time on Monday at the Blackpool Bash. And then they'll meet at the recreation ground. I think it'll be might be August bank holiday or something like that. So I think it was up. Oh no, the Cal Forber going off. There's a kick through and into touch. So this is exactly the same score as the Ike Southard Trophy game up here. Was it 20? Was either 26 or 28-0? I'm looking at Dave and I'm getting nothing off him. But either way, it's been a poor effort today by Haven, it's got to be said. Some of the tackling's been pretty good, mind you. But then again, some of it's been pretty poor. But it really stands more than five tries that Town have scored. And that's what it is. Five tries and three conversions and a penalty. And that was big Scott McAvoy there, threw a dummy, but it wasn't taken. Well, that's much better passing there, but the Town defence just stood rock still there and he did its job. James Newton goes from dummy half, finds the halfway line. Oh, a final tackle. And kick down to the Town try line. I've got to say, poor atmosphere here today. It really is. You would have expected the Town supporters to be in better voice than they are. But to be honest, they haven't really had much to play against. So up goes the cry, get him back. Well, he is right that time, mind you. Wide of him at a mile offside to kick over the top. And Richard Lepore got a nice bounce that time. Oh, and I think that's the first time he's actually got past the player today, but he couldn't get past the second one. So Jesse Dewar takes that line on, but he's not having much luck either.
Thank you.
So Haven trying that right answer. Oh, lost it on a one-on-one. Richard Laporte should get to him, and he does. And Haven are streaming back, but they could be caught short here. It seemed that nobody wanted to tackle Petty Whiteley there. And he's going to go in. Yeah. And there goes the 30 points. It's now Town 32, Haven 0. And really very, very poor defence there. But give Town their due. They were up like a shot, and they went from left to right, and they certainly do like that right-hand side, the left-hand side of the Whitehaven defence, and over they went again. It's Town 32, Haven 0.
You never heard such a poor atmosphere there.
Yep, and over that one goes, so Town 34, Haven 0. And I reckon there'll be at round about 15 minutes, maybe a little bit under. But I think the only good thing as far as Haven are concerned, it looks as though they haven't picked any further injuries up. And Mark Shackley there, that was a good forward player. I like to see players spin in the tackle like that. Very difficult to bring to ground when they do that, when they spin. And on two tackles, they've gained about 15 metres there. There's the 40-metre line, they've just crossed it. Graham Mattinson, it's the 30-metre line, kick through. It's picked up by Jesse Jaw, but also put to ground by the kicker, which is Jamie Doran. Throw the dummy there, and almost got through the defence, but we've been saying that all afternoon, almost through, but just can't get a clear run at all. I'm sure Phil Favors will be delighted with Town's defence, and not too unhappy with their attack either. Oh, right into his hands, and over the goal, and this will be 40 points. That was just hurried into that kick there by the Town defence, and the ball went awry, and next thing it's in the Town player's hands and under the bar. So Town 40, Haven 0, on top of the 60-0 last week, so that's 100 points here in two games Haven have conceded. And there's about 10 minutes left, I think, of this game, so it could get worse. Jamie Doran, the ex-Kells lad, who was ex-Wigan and now on loan at Town, has got the man of the match. Some of those Town players are offside here. Well, anyhow, it's bounced dead, so it'll be a 20-metre restart. They're even shouting for forward passes. Well, that patently wasn't a forward pass. But like seven-a-side rugby here, they're playing. And Jesse Joe regained the ground lost and maybe a yard or two on top. Oop. And on the ball, I think. So just over 20 metres away from the try line. Seems an age since they haven't been down here. And, oh, the ball's gone though. Oh, hang on, it's saying knocked down. So, yeah, it's a scrum to heaven. It's saying knocked down by the Town player. I think if White haven't scored it, it'll be the biggest cheer of the afternoon, although a lot of it will be ironic, of course. So 10 metres out, 5 tackles to go. They've really done a job on Haven, haven't they, today, Town? The defence has been absolutely magnificent. Now, there's a chance. This is Jesse Joe Parker, but put to ground as soon as he got hold of the ball. Looking for a quick play of the ball there, but couldn't get it. Dion Air, nice passing across the line. Oh, kick to the corner. But they're adamant they're not going to let Avon cross that try line. It's final tackle. I don't know if Avon are aware of this. Oh, they put the cross kick in. And yeah, so Town will get the 10-metre restart. So I think we're in the closing minutes. I'll make it 25-5. Oh, in fact, there we go. So full-time score here at the Zebra Claim Stadium. It's Workington Town 40, Whitehaven 0.